minutes that got sent out?
Yep.
Today?
I believe that's correct.
Do they hear something?
Yes, they're in one of those folders, probably in the bottom of Paul's folder. Those are.
Yes, sir. Correspondence. These all put together for a reason, or are these all individual?
I'm pretty sure that they are any type of information.
They're all.
Here from Mr. Jim Lewin, writing to inquire about some repair work that was done to town water pipes leading to my house on Beechwood Ave, Pembroke. Request the town of Pembroke cover the cost. The private machinery used for water department use to perform the work. Please find relevant details.
That's a legit request.
Is it?
Yeah. There was a leak on the town side of the curb slope.
Okay. So, what are we looking for here then?
The extra machine time from the gentleman that he had hired. So it's like $300.
Okay.
I'll make a motion that we pay the additional machine time on the property is this? On Beechwood to Beechwood Ave.
What's up?
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Uh, 230 Beach, Birch Street. Lived in present average 30 years. Recent water bills, 4 times more than previous bills. Recently informed by a water department employee that he had to replace a badly damaged meter. Requesting an abatement, I have to pay the amount of $1,000.
And that was found to be a rotted freeze plate on the bottom of the meter.
Okay.
From being in the sand at the meter pit. So it was not a frozen meter.
So would that cause the usage to
it
be
went, nice? Went through the downstream side of the meter.
Okay.
And it's all sand, so.
So.
When we find these things, do we rectify the new installation when we put a new meter in, or do we just put it back in the sand?
No, I think it's back in the sand. We can have them go do something different. If there's room. I don't know if there's room in the pit to be able to bring it up out of the sand or not. Depends on how tight the copper coming in is. Can look at it though.
Do we know how old this meter is? I'm just concerned that, you know, 6 months from now, or probably not that soon, but 2 years from now, certainly.
No, I've never seen one rot out that fast.
This
only once it's been in there a long time.
It says it's been in there since 2012. So that's not that old.
4 years. 3.5 years.
Yeah.
These meter pits.
Is this a meter pit or was it in the basement?
No, this was in a meter pit for two services, for two different houses.
When we remedy issues in these pits, do we make an attempt to, you know, address things like this?
No, usually, because meter pits, way back, and the regs are going to have to be looked at. We're all on the homeowners, because it's way back when, and now you got new homeowners. But most of these are the old just made out of barrel block and cement covers, septic systems.
How did we inherit the meter pits then if they were originally on the homeowners?
Well, we didn't do anything to the meter pits.
No, but I mean, how do we inherit the responsibility then of what happens in the meter pit? If these meter pits were built by former homeowners to accommodate meters, and the homes have been sold and sold and sold, as I understand it to be, when did the town end up with the ownership of the meter pits? This is something I was thinking about.
You'd have to go back and find out when they were installed. Most of them were installed by Water Division personnel pre-DPW, when they used to do all their own taps and services. So I couldn't tell you if it was homeowners that installed them, made these pits or not.
Yeah, so in most...
But, like I said, you didn't inherit any repairs or anything. It's just the meter from age brought it out the bottom of the plate and needed to replace it. So, yeah.
I agree in one sense, but we've inherited a situation. For example, let's just take this to be verbatim, that meter was put in about 3.5 years ago.
It says it on the thing. It does say it was installed 10/16/12.
Right, so it was installed 3.5 years ago, and it rotted out. If we go back and put the meter back in the same location, you know, maybe newer products and so on and so forth, they don't rot out as quickly. But certainly we're not. We got to figure out what happens with these things.
Okay.
Just because.
No, because you got the same in some of the areas around the ponds that the meters are just laying in the sand
because
there's no finished basement.
Right, and you know, some of them rot out quicker than others, and some, for some reason, never rot out. Mm-hmm.
Well, you're saying there's more than one meter in that pit?
Yeah, it's two different services.
So did we look at the other meter to see what...
They changed it and upgraded that one.
What was the damage to that one?
They didn't say.
Look at this, if it was the same conditions.
Yeah, but
what's going on?
Yeah, even beyond that, it just doesn't make any sense to put it back in the sand.
Mm-hmm.
If we're going to say that the sand rotted it out, then, you know, put a loop on the thing or something, piece of pipe, and just get it up out of the sand.
Okay.
If we're gonna own these meter pits, because I'm sure there's other letters in there, because I read them, we'll get to them about meter pit situations. We're going to own these meter pits in those situations, and when we fix them, we should try to fix them so that we get some longevity out of them.
I'm just trying to see if I'm trying to pull up the map upon it to see why is this one of a meter pit not in the basement?
Well, it's probably a couple hundred foot run.
Right.
And a lot of these ones are old irrigation lines.
Yeah.
So it's not even copper tube size plastic, you know,
hose
clamps. And
yeah, understood.
From way
yeah,
back.
Way back, yeah. They were cottages converted and so on and so forth. But we should.
Yeah, I agree.
You know, just try to help ourselves a little bit. Because we're spending the labor and effort to do it, so. Go ahead. Sorry.
Any motion on this one?
There was a rotted meter. The normal usage be, because this is from
I'd say somewhere in that range,
right, somewhere in the 300 range.
Yeah.
Because these are the bills here.
Yeah.
Here, so I would
130?
Yeah, I would make a motion to reduce this bill, this $1,059, Paul, down to $320, which is in between the range of the bills.
What, so you want a motion to that?
I'm making the motion.
You ready to make a motion?
That we abate the...
Okay, I'll second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Does that include...
320.
Removing the frozen meter charge as well? Was there one on that?
Yes.
Bill?
Yes.
Yeah.
If that's
yeah.
in there, I don't see that in the bill.
Take the 1,059 down to 320.
Okay. There's no bill. It's just the.
They're waiting on the answer for that.
Yeah.
Okay. Just received a. This is this. Uh, 295, looking for an abatement on their bill due to a silent leak in their toilet.
295 Pleasant?
295 Pleasant Street.
Silent leak in the toilet. That's the homeowner's responsibility.
Aren't they asking? They're asking to...
A lower rate.
No, they want to pay it, but they want to...
Pay it at the
lower rate. Pay it at a lower, at the lowest rate.
At the base rate versus the total. Or even not at the base rate, they're looking to pay it...
Lowest tier.
At the lowest, yeah.
What's the bill?
Actually, no, they're not looking, they're looking to go to the medium tier, not even the lowest tier. According to the letter.
Yeah, they're looking to go to the medium tier. The bill was,
The bill was $917.88. So that would be...
Did we find the problem with the toilet? Do we call to find the problem with the toilet in the...
Yes.
Yeah, we tagged it when the readings came in, because it was a high one.
Right.
It wasn't, you know, something that had been consistently high.
Right, so
when we get the high low report...
We sent somebody out.
We sent someone out.
And, you know, we told them...
Well, the only thing I'm concerned with is the fact is that everyone can tell us that the high bill is based on that. And I don't want to get in a policy.
No, right. We found it, I guess. And, you know, they're acknowledging the fact that it's their responsibility. They just like to pay it at the medium rate instead of the high rate.
Stuff's and stuff at that one rate.
Yeah.
What was it?
I'll say what it's going to be, 4.98 minus 7.6. It's up to 30,000.
The first 30,000 is three, yeah.
We're going for the 50,000 tier. So it's only 140. It's 90,000 gallons. It's a, if I do the math right, it's only a $90 difference in the bill. 7.56 minus 4.9.
Yeah, when you base it out with the 30, with 30,000 as the...
The first 50. No, the first 50. He's hanging on his thing. He wants to go down to the 498, which is the second
for
tier.
For anything over 30,000, he wants to go into the second
yeah.
tier.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. When you do the math, it's not. It's actually not that bad.
No.
So I'll let it go to the second.
Motion.
What's the address?
295 Pleasant Street.
Motion to take 295 Pleasant Street leak situation and reduce the consumption rate to the middle tier.
All those in favor? Aye. Marion Way, 7 Marion Way. Had a white pipe break in the winter. When the snow plow comes to the end of Marion Way, they put snow on the property, which you don't mind. So we were not aware of the leak. When the snow melted, we saw the big puddle. Please consider us for a rebate.
That's another one. Meter pits out on Bartlett Street. That's a long plastic line, a full plastic line. They had repaired and replaced in the spring.
So the leak in the yard?
Going up the roadway.
Was it on the other side of the meter? Or
yeah,
or?
No, this side.
But in, not inside the building?
No, in the attic. In the right of way up there to get the couple of houses.
They used 838,000 gallons through the meter for a bill of 6,184.
Wouldn't your water pressure drop?
Up there, I don't even know if you'd notice a difference on those old plastic lines. You know, it's not a not a complete break where you're gonna lose all your pressure. You wouldn't.
No, but I'm thinking a small plastic line. If you're losing 8,000 gallons, I mean, whatever it was.
There's no idea how long it was leaking anyway.
Well, this is showing you what happens for a month.
In the past, on these outside the building ones, we have abated.
Then we go to the lowest rate on something like that. Is that what we?
That's what we did.
That's what we did in the past, yes.
Yeah, we took the consumption and went to the lowest rate. You're talking about an $8,000 bill.
It's gonna be a lot of money.
Right.
Yeah.
When you go to the lowest rate, it's probably 5,500 when we calculate it out.
The problem is that the right players are still trying to pump all that water.
No, I understand that. This is where I'm, I go.
It's where it's hard.
That's $3,150.
So it takes it to half.
Make a motion to table that for further discussion. And to give it some thought as to how to handle that.
Or do we do it the way we did the last guy?
Well,
what's the difference between him and the last guy?
The last guy had a rotted meter in the pit.
No.
This.
The guy who had a leaky toilet.
Oh, we changed the rate.
That's what I'm saying.
I don't think I'm adverse to changing the rate. What I'm struggling with is how to handle these runs from the meter pits to the houses. I mean, this is a situation where the snow got built up there and no one could see the leak. But we lost, you know, how many thousand gallons of water that's now gonna, I mean, tonight already we've you know, put $5,000 or $6,000 back into the kitty that everybody else is paying for. It doesn't go away.
No.
Just because we abate these things, it doesn't go away.
Right.
That everybody else pays for it.
Well, that's kind of why I think the best thing we can do is stick with what we've been doing best. Is to, I mean, it went through the meter. The problem is it went through the meter. If it breaks before the meter, we're still losing that water, but it's not. No one's basically calculating a cost.
If you had the same break at your house right now, you would have paid $0 for it.
Because it would have been up front, not inside.
Right, it's before the meter.
Yeah, but the point is his meter's out at the curb versus in your basement like yours.
However, the length of pipe from there to the house is not the town's responsibility. And I understand that they're plastic lines and the like. Unfortunately, that's the nature of the beast.
Well, we've had it before with people with breaks from their meter going to their bonds.
Right,
where
right.
We've given, I believe, gone to a reduction to the lowest. Realistically, it would be great if you didn't have to do any of it. The break didn't occur, but it occurred. It's no fault of the department, no fault of the owner, but it's not the fault of the people who are paying down the road, because you have breaks everywhere that the rates have to go up. And that's not right either.
No. Make your motion.
I'd make a motion to go to the lowest rate based on the water going through the meter. And just like this. Just like these calculations here, if you have a leak shown in a month, if you have a 3/8.
So homeowners that installed them, made these pits or not?
Yeah, so in most.
But, like I said, that you didn't inherit any repairs or anything, it's just the meter from age rotted out the bottom of the plate and needed to replace it. So, yeah.
I agree in one sense, but we've inherited a situation. For example, let's just take this to be verbatim that meter was put in about 3.5 years ago.
It says it on the thing. It does say it was installed 10/16/12. That's the first one I was.
Right, so it was installed 3.5 years ago, and it rotted out. If we go back and put the meter back in the same location, you know, maybe newer products and so on and so forth, they don't rot out as quickly, but certainly we're not, we gotta figure out what happens with these things.
Okay.
Just because...
No, because you got the same in some of the areas around the ponds that the meters are just laying in the sand.
Right,
because there's no finished basement.
Right, and you know, some of them rot out quicker than others, and some, for some reason, never rot out. Mm-hmm.
Well, you're saying there's more than one meter in that pit?
Yeah, it's two different services.
So did we look at the other meter to see what...
They changed it and upgraded that one.
What was the damage to that one?
They didn't say.
Look at this, if it was the same conditions.
Yeah, but
what's going on?
Yeah, even beyond that, it just doesn't make any sense to put it back in the sand.
Mm-hmm.
If we're going to say that the sand rotted it out, then, you know, put a loop on the thing or something, piece of pipe, and just get it up out of the sand.
Okay.
If we're gonna own these meter pits, because I'm sure there's other letters in there, because I read them, we'll get to them about meter pit situations. We're going to own these meter pits in those situations, and when we fix them, we should try to fix them so that we get some longevity out of them.
I'm just trying to see if I'm trying to pull up the map upon it to see why is this one of a meter pit not in the basement?
Well, it's probably a couple hundred foot run.
Right.
And a lot of these ones are old irrigation lines.
Yeah.
So it's not even copper tube size plastic, you know,
yeah,
it's hose clamps. And
yeah, understood.
From way
yeah,
back.
Way back, yeah. There were cottages converted and so on and so forth. But we should.
Yeah, I agree.
You know, just try to help ourselves a little bit. Because we're spending the labor and effort to do it, so. Go ahead. Sorry.
Any motion on this one?
There was a rotted meter. The normal usage be, because this is from
I'd say somewhere in that range,
right, somewhere in the 300 range, because these are the bills here.
Yeah.
Here, so I would
130?
Yeah, I would make a motion to reduce this bill, this $1,059, Paul, down to $320, which is in between the range of the bills.
Right, so you want a motion to make that?
I'm making the motion.
You ready to make the motion?
That we abate the...
Okay, I'll second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Does that include...
320.
Removing the frozen meter charge as well? Was there one on that?
Yes.
Bill?
Yeah,
if that's
yeah.
in there, I don't see that in the bill.
Take the $1,059 down to $320.
Okay. There's no bill. It's just the.
They're waiting on the answer for that.
Yeah.
Okay. Just received a. This is this. $295, looking for an abatement on their bill due to a silent leak in their toilet.
$295 Pleasant?
$295 Pleasant Street.
Silent leak in the toilet. What's the homeowner's responsibility?
They're asking to...
lower rate.
No, they want to pay it, but they want to
pay it.
They
want
to pay it at a lower
at the
lower
lowest
rate.
At the base rate versus the total, or even not at the base rate. They're looking to pay it
lowest tier.
At the lowest, yeah.
What's the bill?
Actually, no. They're not looking. They're looking at the medium tier, not even the lowest.
Oh.
Tier. According to the letter.
Yeah. We're looking to go to the medium tier.
The bill was $917.88. So that would be...
Did we find the problem with the toilet? Did we call to find the problem with the toilet?
Yes.
Yeah, we tagged it when the readings came in because it was a high one.
Right.
It wasn't, you know, something that had been consistently high.
Right.
So when we get the high-low report.
We sent somebody out.
We sent someone out.
And, you know, we told them.
Well, the only thing I'm concerned with is the fact is that everyone can tell us that the high bill is based on that. And I don't want to get into a policy.
No, right. We found it, I guess. And, you know, they're acknowledging the fact that it's their responsibility. They just like to pay it at the medium rate instead of the high rate.
Stocks are stepping down on the rate.
Yeah.
What was it?
I'll tell you what, it's going to be 4.98 minus 7.6. It's up to 30,000.
The first 30,000 is three, yeah.
We're going for the 50,000 tier. So it's only 140. It's 90,000 gallons. It's about, if I do the math right, it's only a $90 difference in the bill. 7.56 minus 4.9.
Yeah, when you base it out with the 30, with 30,000 as the.
The first 30 is.
No, the first 50, he's saying on his thing, he wants to go down to the 498, which is the second tier.
For anything over 30,000, he wants to go into the second tier.
Yeah, but that's what I'm saying, is when you do the math, it's not, I don't think it's actually not that bad.
No.
So let it go to the second.
Motion.
What's the address?
295 Pleasant Street.
Motion to take 295 Pleasant Street leak situation and reduce the consumption rate to the middle tier.
All those in favor? Aye. Marion Way, 7 Marion Way. Had a white pipe break in the winter. The snow plow comes to the end of Marion Way. They put snow on the property, which you don't mind. So we were not aware of the leak. When the snow melted, we saw the big puddle. Please consider us for a rebate.
That's another one. Meter pits out on Bartlett Street. That's a long plastic line, full plastic line. They had repaired and replaced in the spring.
So the leak in the yard?
Going up the roadway.
Was it on the other side of the meter? Or
yeah, no, this side.
But in, not inside the building?
No, in the attic. In the right of way up there to get to a couple of houses.
They used 838,000 gallons through the meter for a bill of 6,184.
Wouldn't your water pressure drop?
Up there, I don't even know if you'd notice a difference on those old plastic lines. You know, it's not a complete break where you're going to lose all your pressure. You wouldn't.
No, but I'm thinking a small plastic line. If you're losing 8,000 gallons, I mean, whatever it was.
There's no idea how long it was leaking.
Well, this is showing you what happens for a month.
In the past, on these outside the building ones, we have abated.
Didn't we go to the lowest rate or something like that? Is that what we?
That's what we did.
That's what we did in the past. Yes.
Yeah, we took the consumption and went to the lowest rate. You're talking about an $8,000 bill.
It's going to be a lot of money.
Right.
Yeah.
You go to the lowest rate, it's probably 500 when we calculate it out.
The problem is that the ratepayers are still trying to pump all that water.
No, I understand that. This is where I'm, I go.
It's where it's hard.
That's $3,150.
takes it to half.
Make a motion to table that for further discussion. Need to give it some thought as to how to handle that.
What do we do with the way we did the last guy?
Well, the
what's the difference between him and the last guy?
The last guy had a rotted meter in the pit.
No.
This.
The guy who had a leaky toilet.
Oh, we changed the rate.
That's what I'm saying.
I don't think I'm adverse to changing the rate. What I'm struggling with is how to handle these runs from the meter pits to the houses. I mean, this is a situation where the snow got built up there and no one could see the leak. But we lost, you know, how many thousand gallons of water that's now gonna, I mean, tonight already we've you know, put $5,000 or $6,000 back into the kitty that everybody else is paying for. It doesn't go away.
No.
Just because we abate these things, it doesn't go away.
Right.
Everybody else pays for it.
Well, that's kind of why I think the best thing we can do is stick with what we're doing best. Is to, it went through the meter. The problem is it went through the meter. If it breaks before the meter, we're still losing that water, but it's not, no one's basically, cost.
If you had the same break at your house right now, you would have paid $0 for it.
Because it would have been up front, not inside.
Right, it's before the meter.
Yeah, but the point is his meter's out at the curb versus in your basement like yours.
However, the length of pipe from there to the house is not the town's responsibility. And I understand that they're plastic lines and the like. Unfortunately, that's the nature of the beast.
Well, we've had it before with people with breaks from their meter going to their bonds.
Right,
where
right.
We've given, I believe, gone to a reduction to the lowest. Realistically, it would be great if you didn't have to do any of it. The break didn't occur, but it occurred. It's no fault of the department, no fault of the owner, but it's not the fault of the people who are paying if down the road, because you have breaks everywhere, that the rates have to go up. That's not right either. $1,275,800 gallons per month.
Yeah.
That could be happening anyway. A quarter of an inch opening is close to 600,000 gallons a month. You know, people have to be cognizant of leaky toilets, dripping faucets, things like that, because if the new permitting is not going to be, you know, water restrictions or things like that in the future,
right.
Things like this. Abatement process, because that's going to work into our calculation.
Right.
It's going to be important.
Yeah.
People have to be aware that, you know, the town just can't abate constantly.
I'll second the motion to go to the lower tier.
Can you add in request that they have their meter changed up? Because their meter is from 2003, or assuming they're probably due for meter change up?
May have already done it. I know the guys were supposed to dig up the meter pit.
That's all.
Part of the
I just didn't know
townwide.
If it was one of those ones that they couldn't get to or whatever. But
if it's something that has to do with the bottom of the meter, if it's damaged, then we can revisit this.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. 16 Redwood Circle, received a phone call. When the property was transferred in this one, the realtor gave the wrong new owner name, so the bill was not received by the actual new owner, and she is asking for a waiver of the late fees and interest due to the fact she never got her bill.
Where'd the bill go?
Probably to the old owner. Whatever information's in the computer.
Yeah, but that's what I'd like to know, because if it's the address, might have the wrong name, it still goes to the house. Unless in the computer, it's being sent somewhere else.
To a post office or something.
Right, the bill still goes to, you know, whatever the, whatever. Where did this bill go?
Where'd the tax bill go?
We did have this discussion in the past, and I don't know where you guys ever ended up with it, of supposed to be saying whether or not we can put the address, force it to go to the address, whether or not the person lives there or not, or current resident, so it doesn't get forwarded, because the these bills should be going to the house address. So it should be to the, or current owner.
But when did it become, when did it become the relative's responsibility to make sure that their name is on the proper utilities that they're coming to your house?
When they call in for the final, the realtor does that. They're the ones that do it. We get the information from them.
Right, but is it their responsibility? That's the question.
We have made it their responsibility to give us the information so
right.
that we can transfer the
so
bill to
them.
So
where did the tax bill go to? The tax bill go to the proper person?
Tax bills are a little different because they're paid forward.
It doesn't show interest or anything. It shows a final read.
You will set money aside in escrow, so
well,
it doesn't happen right away.
That's true, but not always.
Recording at Plymouth County Deeds could take up to 3 to 6 months, depending on how backed up they are. So
right,
usually it's a 3 month process.
Right, but how old is this bill?
That's probably right around the time of the new bills go out.
See, this, all we have at the moment is a bill from 3 of 2015 to 6 of 2015, and it shows a final read, and it shows current charges, and it shows going to the address, Redwood Circle. There's a lot of scuttlebutt and discussion here about bills going to somebody else at another address, but we don't have any of that here. And we don't have any interest charges or late fees there to even discuss. So if we have something else in house that we can look at that goes with that, we certainly can do that. Right, but it doesn't show here. It doesn't reflect that. This
the new owner shouldn't have been paying for the final read.
Yeah, when did
this is from 3/15.
The name's not even mentioned.
Right. Yeah, but we don't even have this. We don't have anything. We don't have anything about Tim Hovey. We've got a final reading and a Bridget bill.
We could always make the
and there's no interest charges on here. There's no late fees on here.
Did the bill get taken care of at the closing?
The final bill was done on 6/15.
When did they move into the house?
Closing date was 6/29.
Received a phone call from owner Bridget Henderson stating that she's the owner of the property, okay? But the bill was addressed to Tim Hovey. Well, none of these bills are addressed to him.
Nope.
No.
That was the information given to us by the realtor.
Right. But this bill is addressed to the address. And it doesn't show any late
right.
fees or anything. There's
well, because you can't print out old bill. It changes all of the stuff in the system. So Sue's just trying to do what's on the account for right now.
But then why is the new owner paying for the
final
fee? I don't know. That doesn't make any sense. So.
No.
This goes back to the we have the real estate agent in to come in and talk to us about final reads. It's the only town I work in that has problems with all this name changes and all this stuff. If I'm talking to one person, they did say that we're the only town that you can't get it. Like done electronically, you have to come in to sign stuff. Actual homeowner has to come.
Well, they don't have to come in, they have to pay it, and they bring the paid receipt to the closing.
Why can't it be done at the closing?
Because the HUD does not allow anything to be changed 10 days prior to it. So we would have to do the reading 12 days prior to it, and then they want us to estimate how much usage will happen in those 12 days before the actual closing.
That should be fine. why can't you estimate on a daily average of what they're using and put it in there?
We're talking pennies.
Right.
Unless somebody opens up a fire hydrant on the back of their house, they're not going to use more than $3 worth of water. They're not going to use 1,000 gallons in 10 days. But it's just an ongoing issue, so the sooner we
get... Well, that one's more... It should be the real estate agent's responsibility. We have the real estate agent's information. We should kick it back to them. It's they're the ones that gave the bad information.
I know. I'm just saying we continuously have discussions.
Well, it's funny. Now that we have the new trig laws,
yeah,
all the realtors are saying, you guys are actually the only ones that are doing it right. Because everything is changing for everybody else and is pushing their closings back because they're not getting all the information in a timely fashion.
Okay, that's not what I've heard, but that's fine. I just think we continuously have issues with new owner names and we need to get it fixed sooner or later because it's every 3 months we have an issue with a new owner name.
Yeah, that one there.
Not getting forwarded and...
There's not even enough information for us to do anything with at the moment. But that one we're off the table until we can figure it out. There's got to be some backup someplace.
Pembroke Housing Authority, to us. Today I paid 30. Account numbers attached, water bills for the Pembroke Housing Authority, 3 for DBW. Recognize the bills were due on 6/24/16, we're a little late. Traditionally, Pembroke Housing Authority pays bills to the town of Pembroke on time. Payment today is an isolated incident of tardiness, as you're aware. Pembroke Housing Authority serves elderly residents. Therefore, we'd like to appeal the late fee of $10 per account, as it would negatively affect our financial obligations to those we serve.
I'll make a motion to take back the late fees.
Second.
All those in favor? Thank you for speaking to me today. See your history. Late fee in 14 years. Paid the bill through my bank on 11/14 for a due date of 11/6. For whatever reason, it did not post till 11/9. You're supposed to take a minimum of 48 hours to post. Going forward, I'll pay 96 hours in advance to be safer. I hope you can see this one-time exception of 1077 late fee. Or 108 Wintergreen Farm Road.
It's $10, right?
1077. Oh, plus interest. It's the late fees plus interest.
$12. You know what? I hate to bring it up. If I pay my credit card bill late, for whatever reason, it doesn't post, it doesn't go through, I mailed the check, it didn't get out of the post, I don't know, whatever. They don't abate me the late fees.
You can't call them.
You know, and I don't mean to be...
Right. You get it.
But we can't be setting precedents that... I don't know.
Well, it's sent out long enough that it shouldn't be late. It's sent out, what, a month and a half before it's due?
A month, 30 days.
And I appreciate that the bank dropped the ball or right. Whomever. I mean, I've paid credit card bills and that's happened. And it didn't get there on time. And I look and I got a late fee. It happens, I guess.
Yeah,
what I don't want to get into is what used to be when I first came on the board,
the line.
Every meeting there was a line out the door for late fees, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10.
Right.
And we spent more time abating late fees and fighting over them than...
Well, we should have been. Right, so, I don't want to take any action on that.
Second on no action.
Okay. Correspondence? Oh. This is
I think this is one more. 18 Maramesa.
He's supposed to be coming in.
Plus, I always sent the meter out to have a check.
Yep.
What time is he scheduled for here?
I don't know. Sue had called to make the appointment and he didn't.
She didn't get back to us.
He didn't reply back.
Well, so he didn't show up.
The meter came back with 99% accuracy. So what was the situation? Why did we send this meter out? Because
he's my guy. Came in.
The bill was questioned.
Right.
He came in.
Right.
Talked to us.
We said we were going to send the meter out.
Yep.
Right.
Yeah, I think he had a $900.
We agreed to it, and you got the letter in there what the fee was going to be if it came back within specs.
Right. And we have a standing policy. Blah blah blah. And
that's why we send it out to a third party.
And the meter came back at 99% accuracy.
Oh, within.
Well, I suggest that if he shows up, we'll show it to him, and if he doesn't, take the documentation and forward it to him.
He's got it on. He's going on the fact that his consumption the last 2 week periods are back to where they were.
Yeah.
Something occurred that we're not privy to.
The only thing we can do is, if they agree, is pull the meter to send it out and have tested. If it comes back within specs.
Which we did.
Which we did. Right. We followed the policy we established,
and he assumes the cost.
And it is what it is.
There's no way for us to tell what happened in this time frame, other than if the meter had been bad.
Right. Otherwise, the water went through the meter and it went someplace.
That's it for correspondence. On to old business, I guess, because he's not here yet. Water Management Act permit. I actually met with the DEP people on a different project Friday, and he is willing to come in and meet with us. So once we pick a date for our next meeting, I will get him here to discuss the Abington, Rockland, and Brockton restrictions that will be in place and their new permits moving forward. So that's that. Storm Drain as-built.
Still digging through the pile of them. I've located one of them.
Okay.
It's an old plan. I don't think it's the up-to-date one yet. So
okay.
There's still 5 or 6 blocks to dig through up at Glenwood. So
okay.
I'm still working on that.
If we have to go to planning to find that, the one that's going to be the easiest is going to be Milford.
Milford.
So
I haven't come across
that's
the time
fine.
Stat yet.
Okay.
So.
Good enough. Work orders, I know you weren't here last time, Gene. We talked about doing the work orders. Do you want to have them come in and you and I can sit down and we'll go through it and see? I think we decided last time to at least take a heavy look into it. So if you guys don't mind, Gene and I will meet with the software vendor and hammer out what we'd like to do and what
is this through People GIS?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, this.
I'm gonna go.
Has Gene been filled in on what we're attempting to do with the work orders?
Well, I know what some
other
towns are doing.
Yeah. He wasn't
as
here.
As
and he was out on a family emergency.
Yes.
So
as far as I know, we're already all set with People GIS through our stormwater.
Yes.
Okay.
So you're just adding on another module
for the work orders.
To do work orders.
Mm-hmm.
So would it even tie into all those assets that are being collected for stormwater? They'd be able to tag on a work order to, oh, that catch basin needs to be rebuilt or whatever. So, and it's the same system that building department's using too. So it could even be the point where we all talked about the idea of those checkoffs on whether somebody damaged a sidewalk during a building permit when Scott does his final inspection.
Right.
If he found another thing while he's out there, he could create a work order while he's doing the checkoff on the actual building permit inspection. So he
put
it
right in the iPad, right in.
Mm-hmm.
Done. While he's out doing something else.
While he's doing it.
So.
But how many iPads do we have? That we
none
use?
On the DPW side. We have
so
few with the water.
Yeah. So we gonna look at costs?
Yeah, that's what when we sit down, we'll go through the whole thing and come back to
I think we're only talking about two.
Yeah.
But then again, is the question, do you want to have, do you, does this tie into a to a computer at like the bond where down there they can look at work orders that have been generated?
It could be, yes.
And then they have a printer that could go right out?
Yes.
Right, right. But they don't necessarily need the iPad connection because,
no, because Scotty would
get them all at the end of the day or collect them up periodically and go through them and enter what's been done or see what's going on, follow up on them, and so on and so forth. And then Gene would just have a track record right at his desk. And somebody calls up from the public and says, you know, here's what's going on, and Gene can pull it right up and say, here's what we've done. We're on it, or we didn't know anything about it.
So, we'll do that. Hopefully we'll have something for the next meeting. Highway Garage, you guys have a chance to take a look through those. Did you get a copy of these, Gene?
No.
I did. Have you guys had a chance to take a look at
it? Yeah, I started looking through it, yes. Yes.
Any comments or questions about it? We can table it till next time if you want.
I do have some. I haven't gone all the way through.
Yeah.
I'm looking at the amount of tasks and what's in each task and kind of consolidating in my mind how far we need to go task by task because that's how we pay these things.
Yes.
So I think one more week or one
that's
round of meeting,
yep.
I'll have more question and I think we can speak more intelligently about it.
Perfect.
I got through the first couple of pages. Well, I don't want to preempt and start talking about it because I didn't go all the way through, and some of it might tie back at a later task.
Yeah, that's fine. You were working on the outline for DPW.
There should be a second sheet. What I did initially is I began to create the position of the director, duties, responsibilities, requirements, and I walk down through that, talk about salary and education, and walk down through that. This is sort of the first pass at it. I didn't feel the need that we need to get really into the minutia. It's a position that has certain responsibilities, certain educational requirements, certain salary requirements, and the contract speaks to the rest of it. So it seems like it's a small pass at it, but you guys take a look at it and fill in the blanks and see what you want to do with it. So we'll keep this, Rose, attached to the meeting minutes for the next meeting.
And I haven't actually started on that. But basically, the way I would look at it is the duties of the director, the assistant director should be able to do those. And the salary's different.
Or assist in doing all of those.
Correct. To be able to take in, because if the director is out for it, could be a month, something could happen.
Right.
You need a person to be able to step into that.
Right.
And to be able to be it should be seamless.
Well, I think what'll happen is once you go through that and you put yours together and we go through them, you'll see the interaction between them.
Right.
And you're right. It's almost interchangeable.
Exactly.
It is interchangeable.
Well, it should be because theoretically, realistically, it should be kind of director. And the assistant is usually the person that you want to step up in that position.
At some point
to take
in time,
over.
Yeah.
So the goals, some of the education may be there. Some of the education may have to be developed as he's on that job.
Right.
Or gone for extra education to comply with the job application for the director's position. But that's kind of how I look at it. Here we have a different situation because we have got guys that have about the same amount of years in service, and it could make it tough for the town if all of a sudden
they both go at the same time.
Retire at the same time.
Okay.
Of course, this has nothing to do with you guys.
Public comments. Buddy? And schedule business for after the posted meeting?
I was told that Selectman Stone was coming in to see you guys at 7:30.
Oh, okay. 7:30.
We'll be here a while.
7:30?
That's what I was told just before we came in.
Okay.
Stuff moves faster.
We can do that. Yep, we can do that.
I have a meeting at 7 about replacing our...
See if we can get a call to him to tell him to be on the next agenda so he doesn't show up, because they don't have a meeting tonight.
It's Stone, right?
What's the update on Route 14? Any update?
Ongoing drainage. We're waiting to hear back from John from PA Landis. He's trying to set up a meeting with the state. We have one issue with the head wall, and we're going to deal with it, so we're just waiting to hear from him so we can meet with him and the state guys. They probably got another couple of days of tree work, and the tree work will be wrapped up. National Grid's starting to move wires.
So that the highways and
Haven't seen any Verizon trucks out there yet, so I don't know what their timeline is. But Edison National Grid is moving right along. I think they probably got maybe another 35 poles to set, I think.
Yeah, and they had their crews back in set poles again today. So.
Yeah.
I had a question on the tree removal. Down by Pembroke, right across at the property the airport's at.
Yep.
Is that large tree there that's cabled? What's the, is that being affected? Is that being taken down? Is it?
It's out of the layout.
It's out of the layout.
Okay. I think we might run into some resistance if we try to get that on the takedown list.
Well, I would be concerned of its sturdiness.
That's
forward.
That's why they cabled it.
No, I understand that. Well, they're trying to save it. But it's going to come a time when it's going to come down, no matter how many cables are put in it. Is the property owner against taking it down, or is the property owner?
The old one was. I don't believe the new one's been approached about it.
Okay. I'm just looking at it from a safety point of view, not from a
aesthetic,
because I think it has a lot of hazard built into it.
We can talk to the new homeowner down there and then get together with...
I know it'll cost extra to take it down, but while things are going on, it may be cheaper to take it down now than to wait.
That's something, if you guys deem it, you want it down and we get the homeowner's wish, that's something we can do with our own equipment. We have to find it out.
Gene, did T.L. Edwards ever respond we last met, and we were waiting for response on the roads and the repairs that were going to be made, paving and so on.
Yeah, just waiting for their schedule guy to get back to us. They came out and took their dig safes for the rest of Old Washington Street and Edison Street. They're going to be milled and then leveled. They're coming back for taking elevations and inverts for 5 structures that have to be replaced on Route 27 before the top goes down. So the game plan is to get them in here and get the milling level and done, and then they want to come to town and put all the top wear and course on all those streets.
And those are the ones that we had spoken of back in the winter time that we were going to take care of to get us current.
Right, because the top wear and course never went on plain
right.
L,
right.
Section of 27 and Old Washington.
Okay.
Yep.
I assume they'll get done this year.
Oh, yes. Yeah. Because I know I want 27 done before kids go back to school.
Okay. After our last meeting, I did stop in to the selectmen's meeting and ask them about our pavement. So stuff, and they said, if we're looking to get it on, to try and start meeting with advisory, and also come into them more like November timeframe, like we had planned on trying to do last year. So that should probably be our game plan on that.
I know Mike Buckley has reached out to me, and he was going to try and touch base in Rockland and see how they did the bonding for the 3 years they did the $6,222,222.
I would rather not do it that way, just personally. I want to get it in budget, because otherwise, that's just my personal.
Well, I think what Mike was trying to get at was put it in the budget.
Oh.
For $300,000 to $500,000.
There he is.
A year. X amount of years.
Okay.
Because I told him $300,000 will get you maybe even.
Yeah.
$500,000 to go with $500,000 you get a year, you can start to gain. What's the difference between however long you bond between $300,000 and $500,000?
Well, isn't the idea to get into regular maintenance?
That's right. What I mean. I don't want
to bond. Instead of trying to.
You'd like to get an extra $500,000 in the budget,
yeah,
to go with the $500,000 Chapter 90. So we've got roughly $1 million to work with a year based on the pipe management plan to start seeing increase.
Right, but what Paul is saying is rather than that being a bond issue, being a line item.
Well, it would be a line item. It's how they could pay for it.
Yeah, but
well, the problem is,
but then put it in the debt schedule.
I don't want
but then 5 years or 7 years down the road, you're back in the same situation.
I don't want that way. I personally don't.
I think it
should
be built in.
I want it in the budget or I don't want it.
No, what I'm saying is it would be in the budget. But it would be like this, just like the schools, $1.3 million they get in every year through the debt exclusion. That's what they were trying to look at.
Yeah, but here's the...
But they don't get...
That's not...
That's
they only get it once. They only get that once.
It's not going to happen once.
No, but that was an override vote.
Right.
That's, if we're going for an override vote, yeah, that's a different question. But at bonding, we're not bonding.
Well, that's what it would be based on, the debt exclusion. To pay back the bond.
Right.
They're trying to do it for the streets and pavement just like they did for the schools.
Yeah. Mr. Stone, you're up.
I'm up.
You are.
Okay. I was waiting until your...
We're into unscheduled business.
Oh, you are?
Yes.
Very good.
I was trying to find your phone number because I was afraid we were going to call you and say we're adjourning. You might need a...
I just want to get some information on your drainage project at the high school.
Okay.
I did get a copy of this.
May I see that, please?
Sure. I believe we got it from Gene.
Mm-hmm.
I requested from Ed to get some information on that project.
Okay.
The reason being is that I'll just speak for myself and not the board. Getting a lot of calls from people saying, what the hell's going on Hobbamock Street? How come we got so many trucks? What are they doing? And so forth and so on. Now you say, well, look, this money was appropriated at town meeting, $385,000. Legitimate project, no question about it. Conservation's involved, schools are involved, and you guys are involved. The only thing I would like to see is when this graph of the project was completed and you knew what was going on and how long it was going to take, if we could have heard about it in the selectman's office. Because when we have a private construction project that requires heavy trucks taking soil out of the town, they have to get a permit from the Board of Selectmen. Now, I'm not suggesting that you have to get a permit from the Board of Selectmen, but we would like to know some of the same information that we would ask from a private operation. How many trucks a day? What are the hours of operation? What are the routes the trucks are going to take? These are some of the things that we require before we give a permit. We even have things in there like when they get done at the end of a work day, if there's dirt all over the roads, we require them to sweep it off. I mean, even a small thing like that, but that can be important as well. So I came tonight just to ask you if we could get some additional information on this. We're not trying to regulate your project, but tell you how to do it. We have no knowledge of that at all. I wouldn't presume to say that we do. I'd just like to know some more facts about it. And then when we get calls in the selectman's office, we're not going to give every person that calls all this information.
Yep.
But if somebody says, how long is this project going to last? Are they going to be working 5 days a week, seven days a week? I travel on Bobmock Street with my kids. I don't like dodging all these trucks, you know? I mean, you get a lot of this stuff. But I am in no way, and I want to be very clear, saying that this project isn't a legitimate project. It was approved at town meeting. And it was, conservation was involved. Pointed out the issues. We got engineering in there. And you guys are fixing it. And that's the bottom line of this whole thing.
Yeah, we got to throw in an outlap, so we're just trying to rectify the problem and move forward.
Right.
But yeah, but I forwarded those to you for selectmen and to the commissioners when I got the updated schedule.
Okay.
So that's, I didn't have that long before you got it. But I can get you more information on truck trips and what
yeah,
that land
that's
on.
All I would like to know. Yeah. I mean,
we'll get that.
Yeah,
I mean, think
we'll
that
expedite it, that out to you.
Okay, great.
Absolutely.
It does bring up back to the idea, too, of utilizing the website better. We have been trying to do with Route 14, we should probably do it for every project we do and put out the plans, a copy of the plans on every project we're working on and the schedules and everything right there for everybody to have access to.
Scott, number of trucks, hours of operation, the route that they are currently taking.
The routes are varying because there's some people in town taking some of the fill, which is all set up through the contract and nothing to do with us. And some of the fill is getting, he's got
that's okay.
People for fill.
Let's give this, give Selectman Stone the information and he can disseminate it.
Well, I'm just saying we may not, you know, one day it may be running one route, and the next day it may be running
but
another.
But just
route.
How much fill give them that remote? Information.
How much fill is going to remove?
The last time I was up there, they were probably at about 1,000 yards.
There's how much
about,
more?
There's about 7,000 tolls.
Okay. So none of this fill the town can be using?
Well, we've had residents reach out to us.
Well,
so we're set up with
them. I'm talking about the road to Pine Grove. We were talking about getting filled so we can do a widening on that. I mean, that type of thing, right?
Why yeah,
we utilizing
this
some
material?
Of that?
We've got a stockpile of material
I know,
to take care of anything we're going to do up to Pine Grove.
Right. I just want to make sure that down the road we're not buying something that we already own.
The toughest problem with this project is we didn't have any place to store it. With Monroe Street pit being closed, that's the only place we had to store material.
What's all the wood at Monroe Street?
That is from the high
project.
School drainage project. We'll be offered to the residents.
And there's no room up there to store
we
materials?
As far as I know, we cannot store dirt or anything up there.
Do we need to go before the selectmen and ask them if we can? Because it's money in the town's pocket and utilization by the DPW, so that we don't have to buy this material? Is that something that...
We can send something up if we can start utilizing that site again.
Is that well, I would think if we're utilizing it for the lumber, that we could utilize it for that kind of... It's clean material.
Okay.
It's good material. It's not something that was stored there 35 years
it's
ago.
It's not something
that
to crush.
Yeah, and no one knew what was in the middle of it.
Right.
This is good, clean material that we're going to pay anywhere from $15 to $25 a yard to buy.
Yeah, it's right down the street.
7,000 yards at $25 is a substantial amount of money.
Can we confirm, too, that the stuff's been put up there on Route 30, on Route 14, the schedule? Have we put that up there yet?
Just 2 weeks ago, Sabrina. It has to be updated through Sabrina.
Does
can't put it on our site? They can't put it on like the Mass DOT project?
Yeah, let's not stray with Mr. Stone's time.
I understand, but
am I being unreasonable in thinking that if we spoke with the selectmen and I guess conservation that maybe we could, and I'm not asking you for an answer, but is the premise unreasonable to think that we could bring such a thing forward and discuss it?
I think if the town has a storage place to put fill that the town may have a need for in the future and get it for nothing, I don't know all of the details, but it seems like a pretty simple thing to me. Makes a lot of sense.
And I would think that between Route 14 and what's going to go on Center Street and so on, this material isn't going to sit around for many years. It more than likely, by the time it's piled and sitting there, it's going to start going back out. That's a lot of material to just kind of give away.
Yeah. Well, like I say, I think it's a good idea to be looking ahead as to the fact that we may have a use for material like this, and we would have to purchase it if we weren't able to save this, and we have a place to put it. The material is good, clean material. We know what's in it. Whereas, as Ben said years ago, we had stuff there we didn't know. So it's just a case of, do we have the room? What else do we have planned for that facility? I don't know of anything.
I would make, I don't know if we need a motion, but I'd certainly make a suggestion that we reach out.
You can't make a motion on anything that's not on the agenda.
Okay, I make a suggestion that we reach out to conservation and discuss the potential and see what they would seem to think about stockpiling material on Monroe Street, and then given whatever happens there, get on the selectmen's agenda and have that discussion. We're talking about $200,000 worth of material.
Yeah, I think it's a great idea, and we'd certainly like to hear from you folks with the proposal and conservation's agreement with that, or if they have some conditions. I think you folks, conservation, the commissioners are the people that we need to hear from.
Gene, can you open a dialogue with conservation?
Mm-hmm. I will tomorrow.
And see. So
the question. Here's the question. In the contract, who owns it?
It's just up to them in the contract, I believe, just to get rid of it. Where it went, what didn't matter. That's why when residents started reaching out.
They don't own it, correct?
No, but the question is who's been trucking it?
Right.
When they've been giving it to, wholesale giving it out to another contractors, are they trucking it themselves, or is not trucking it?
The subcontracted trucks, which I don't know if he's hired,
yeah,
or is he selling it to,
yeah,
him? I don't know.
So, well, there may be some cost.
But we get 2 10 wheelers sitting at the barn.
Yeah, to haul it ourselves if they load.
Right.
And I'm sure that's what's going on up there anyway.
Yeah.
So wherever it's going, they're sending a truck and somebody's loading it.
You could say to Naughton, if you're already planning on trucking it to Quincy,
right,
truck
it down the street.
Exactly.
No, I agree with you 100%.
Because they do. It's that fine line. You know what I mean.
I know exactly.
You know from the other end, they'll be like, well, your truck didn't show up on time, so I'm going to give you a back charge for...
You know exactly what you're talking about.
You're in that contracting world. Not a back charge. My guy was sitting around on the loader.
That's right. He wasn't doing anything. If you could start at least a conversation with Conservation, Gene, and see...
Sure, we'll do that and reach out to the contractor.
And reach out to the contractor and see what's going on, and then we can, you know, we can take that information as quickly as we can and go before the selectmen, and maybe we can make a suggestion at that time that this is where we are, and, you know, we think it's a worthwhile idea.
Now, we're on a 2-week schedule meeting.
Okay.
Next Monday night.
Okay.
So I'll be putting together the agenda for that meeting Wednesday afternoon. So you
okay.
can touch base
we'll
with
see what we
Sabrina.
Can. Yeah.
We'd be happy
we'll
to put that on the agenda. And if we have to put it off for some reason that we don't know about tonight, we can certainly do that, but I'd like to get it on the agenda immediately.
Because that would then be, too, would give you a guaranteed truck route, too. That there wouldn't be, oh, the trucks some days are going here.
And time and the whole bit, amount of trucks and everything, we'd be able to.
That'll be great. I'm glad I came. Thank you very much. I think we've got a positive outcome from all of this, how we've discussed how we're gonna make some use of this field that we're taking. I think that's a win-win for all of us here, I think. Thank you very much.
Thank you for coming in.
Thanks.
So can we get on our website, our own project pages?
We can try. I know that we've had issues when we go to put announcements on, it gets bumped.
I don't want an announcement.
It always gets bumped from.
I want it as its own page, like we have the Route 36 project right now.
Okay.
I want to have like DPW project page.
We should have just the DPW page.
We have a DPW page, but I'm saying just have a page with, that has all our projects.
This is page two of the DPW page, and then it goes page three, page four.
No, what I'm saying is, we have mass DOT projects, it could be just reg, and then.
Right, it could be DPW projects, or it could be just DPW and just go on from there.
Yeah, so. I'd like to get some feedback on that for the next meeting. And I'd like to actually see it in place by the next meeting if we can.
I think we should change the page to DPW.
Projects.
DPW projects or what's the word I'm looking for? Just a general heading of the DPW and then under there list different
things.
That's
what I'm saying. If you go to the website page, they have all these tabs down here. So down here would be a DPW projects.
Yeah, so it's another, the tab's another page, yeah, that's right.
That's what you want.
Yep.
So same as that mass DOT project.
Just add another tab.
Current DPW construction projects and put.
Ongoing.
Yeah. And that way they can be on.
Then it's up there.
And one last thing, not on the bin, where are we at on mowing of sidelines of streets?
The mower was out today, having an issue with the machine. And we're in contact with the company right now.
Okay.
Their tech was out last week, and they're having an issue with one of the pieces on the unit, so we're just waiting to hear back from them. It went out today, it ran all day today, so the issue may be cleared up on one machine, and we're just waiting to get the second one set up.
Is it a warranty?
Yes.
Anything else from you guys on that schedule? You want to pick a next meeting date?
Is it for 2 weeks? Are they alternating from the cycle?
If you can, that would be the first. Assuming they're not meeting on the first. Are they going every other week?
Yeah, they're meeting next week. So August 1st.